Hello students, in this video we continue with the animal kingdom classification. The second phylum we deal with is phylum Ctenophora, which are commonly called as sea walnuts or comb jellies. They are exclusively marine animals. They are radially symmetrical and their body is diploblastic with tissue level of organization. The body has got 8 rows of ciliated comb plates externally. So 8 rows of ciliated comb plates are there on the outer side of the body, and these comb plates which help in the locomotion. Digestion is extracellular as well as intracellularly happening, and phylum Ctenophora, these animals, they exhibit bioluminescence. That means the property of the living organisms to emit light. So this Ctenophora is having the ability of bioluminescence, which is an important characteristic of the phylum Ctenophora. Sexual reproduction takes place with external fertilization, and development is indirect. Examples are Ctenoplana and Pleurobrachia. So here you can see the glassy appearance of the Ctenophora with the comb plates, and this one is the bioluminescence. It's like well lit. So bioluminescence is seen. The next phylum is phylum Platyhelminthes, which includes the flatworms. They are the most primitive bilateral animals, and their body is dorsoventrally flattened. That is why they are called as flatworms. And mostly they are endoparasites found in animals including human beings, and they are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and acoelomate animals, and they have the organ level of organization. Until now in Ctenophora also it was tissue level of organization. Now Platyhelminthes onwards we will find the organ level of organization. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasitic forms. Most of them are parasitic, so they will have hooks and suckers, and with the help of the hooks and suckers they get attached to the digestive tract of the animals, like human beings also. So they absorb the nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. They have specialized bodies, specialized cells called as flame cells, which help in excretion. So excretory organs are the flame cells, which helps in osmoregulation also. Sexes are not separate, so you may find both the sexes in the same animal itself. Examples are tapeworm, then liver fluke, planaria. All these are examples of flatworms, and some members like the planaria, they do have the ability to regenerate their lost body part, or if a small body part is cut into pieces, each piece will grow, regenerate into a new animal. Now fertilization is internal and development is through larval stages. Now here you can see the tapeworm. So the head region, you have the scolex. The head is called the scolex, which is having the hooks and the suckers. So these are for attaching itself to the intestinal walls or the digestive tract, wall of the digestive tract, and getting connected, and then it can take in the nutrients through its body surface. In tapeworm, the body is divided into various proglottids or the segments. So in each segment, you will find the reproductive organs, male and female reproductive organs, and the excretory organ is a flame cell. So some organs are present in each of these proglottids or the segments. So that is about the platyhelminthes. So the presence of flame cells for excretion and osmoregulation is one distinct characteristic feature of phylum Platyhelminthes. The next phylum is phylum Aschelminthes, which includes all the roundworms. And their body is cylindrical, tapering at both the ends. Body is without any segmentation. The symmetry is bilaterally symmetrical roundworms. Roundworms are triploblastic also. They have organ system level of organization. And the anterior end does not have any distinct head. No locomotory appendages in roundworms. And the body wall is having a resistant outer covering, which is of cuticle. And the body cavity is present between the body wall and the digestive tract, which is not lined by the mesothelium. So it is called as pseudocoelom. Pseudocoelom is there. So mesothelium is not seen. That means the ectoderm and the endoderm, which are separated, and in between you don't find the mesoderm lining the body cavity. So it is a pseudocoelom. The alimentary canal is complete with a well-developed muscular pharynx, and the excretion is done through excretory tube, which removes the body waste from the body cavity through the excretory pore. These are dioecious animals. Sexes are separate. Male and females are distinct. Often females are longer than the males. And fertilization is internal. Development is direct. There is no young ones will resemble the adults. No larval forms. Examples are Ascaris, which is the round worm. Then Muchararia, that is filarial worm. Then Ancylostoma, which is a hookworm. This figure is of Ascaris. You can see the male and female. The female is longer or bigger than the male. And the male at the posterior end is having a curve-like structure. Males are smaller than the females. Their hind end is curved ventrally, and they have the pineal spicules, which helps them in copulation. Pseudocoel is the unique feature of Aschelminthes. Because till now there were no coelom, acoelomates. Now the body cavity is started seeing, but it is not lined by the mesoderm, so we call it as pseudocoelom. Phylum Arthropoda are the animals with jointed feet. And this phylum is the largest phylum of the animal kingdom, which includes the insects, spiders, scorpions, mites, centipedes, like animals. So all of them are the arthropods, and they are specialized with the jointed legs. That is why the name arthropoda. Now the body is variously shaped in different animals, but it is segmented externally to varying degrees. So you will find the from annelida to arthropoda, annelida is metamerically segmented, but in arthropod you will find external segmentation only. Body is bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic. And these arthropods, they have organ system level of organization. The anterior part of the body forms a distinct head, and the head is formed of fused segments. Many segments fused together form the head, and the head is having sense organs like the eyes, antennae. Then some or all the segments, they bear appendages. Appendages are jointed, which is a characteristic feature of the phylum Arthropoda. Now appendages are variously modified for different functions. Some it may be used for feeding, walking, jumping, swimming. So many different kinds of functions. The body wall is consisting of the chitinous cuticle externally, which is a single layered one, so which does not allow the animal to grow. The cuticle restricts its growth. So the cuticle is periodically changed during the growth. So the shedding of the cuticle is called as molting or ecdysis. The body cavity around the viscera contains blood, so it is called the hemocele. Hemocele means blood is blood filled cavity. It is true coelom is reduced to cavities in the reproductive organs. Now the digestive tract is complete with the mouth and the anus. The respiration occurs through the body surface, that is in some cases, but many of them have special structures for respiration, like the gills, tracheae, book lungs, or book gills or gill books. Now these tracheae are tubes which are carrying oxygen directly into the cells from the outer air. The circulatory system is open type. Blood is flowing in the hemocele to the exterior. Instead of the blood vessels, they have the hemocele. So the blood, which is called as the hemolymph, which is actually colorless, which contains white corpuscles. Then the excretory system is consisting of excretory organ, which is called as the Malpighian tubules. So the Malpighian tubules open into the digestive tract or the gut. Then the nervous system comprises a circumcentric ring, a nerve ring, and a double midventral dorsal midventral nerve cord. Sexes are separate, so fertilization is external in aquatic forms, but it is internal to those majority of the arthropods. Development usually includes larval form, and the larvae undergoes varying degree of metamorphosis to become the adult. So examples are cockroaches, various insects, mosquito, different types of insect carrying vectors are also there. Then many of them are pests, insect pests for the agricultural crop. So some of them are useful, like the honeybee and silk worm moth. Then there is a lac insect. So many. This is the largest phylum with so many number of species. So they will be in all the kinds of habitats and spheres. All right. Now coming to the unique features of the phylum Arthropoda, they have first one jointed appendages. And these jointed appendages perform variety of functions. Then chitinous exoskeleton is another characteristic feature. Then respiration is through tracheae. Eyes, compound eyes are there for seeing, vision. Then malpighian tubules for excretion. Then most of the insects, they do have the power of flight. They can fly. So some parts of these insects you can see. So flight is an important characteristic of Arthropoda. Power of flight. Development is direct or indirect, that is larval forms are there which will grow into the adult. The process is called as metamorphosis. Then in some arthropods like honeybees, the individuals are produced by parthenogenesis, that means without the fertilization the eggs will develop into the individual honeybees. And there are harmful arthropods also, mosquitoes, cockroaches, spiders, all these, many of them are insect vectors or carriers of diseases. This is the metamorphosis of a butterfly, the egg which hatches into the larva which feeds on green leaves and finally reaching the stage called the pupal stage, which is the resting stage. And once it completes the pupal stage, it breaks open the cocoon and comes out as the adult butterfly. The next phylum is phylum Mollusca, the shelled animals or the soft-bodied animals. This is the second largest phylum, and mollusks include mussels, oysters, snails, squids. All of them are the molluscan animals. The body has a variety of shapes and usually is unsegmented. Bilaterally symmetrical animals, and all of them are triploblastic. And they have organ system level of organization. The body is differentiated into three regions: the head with sense organs, then dorsal visceral mass containing organ systems, and ventral foot which is used for locomotion. A thin and fleshy fold or outgrowth of the dorsal body wall more or less covers the body. So this fold or this skin-like part is called as the mantle. And the mantle encloses a space, the mantle cavity, between the mantle and the body. Now the body is covered by calcareous shell. So the mantle usually secretes the external shell of the molluscan. Coelom is greatly reduced. Digestive tract is complete. Buccal cavity contains a rasping organ which is called as the radula. And on the radula, transverse rows of teeth are arranged. So this radula helps in the feeding, which is a rasping organ, which helps in feeding, means it helps in the grinding of the food. Then respiration is takes place by the gills. Gills are the respiratory organs. Now reproduction, sexes are separate. Gonads have ducts, and fertilization is internal. Asexual reproduction is absent. Then excretory organs are one or two pairs of sac-like kidneys. The development includes larval forms. The larva is called Glochidium larva or Veliger larva. Now, what are the unique features of the phylum Mollusca? In Mollusca, the body is divided into head, visceral mass, and the foot. Then the glandular fold of skin, the mantle, which is covering the, which is seen over the body, and mantle cavity with the anal, excretory, and genital apertures in it. So mantle cavity is there. Then there is a calcareous shell around the body, which is normally secreted by the mantle. Then the presence of the rasping organ, the radula, in the buccal cavity. These are the characteristic features of phylum Mollusca. Examples are chiton, octopus, sepia, phyla. All these are the examples of the mollusc. Now next phylum is phylum Echinodermata, the spiny skinned animals. So these include the starfish, then sea urchins, brittle stars, sand dollars. All these are coming under this phylum. The body has various shapes. Some of them are star-like, some with a cylindrical shape, some are like disc-shaped. So these are unsegmented animals, and the symmetry is radial in the adults, but it is bilateral in the larval forms. Radially symmetrical adults and bilaterally symmetrical larval forms are there in the phylum Echinodermata. These are triploblastic animals, and organ system level of organization. The body lacks head in all echinoderms. Then for locomotion, specialized structures which are called as the tube feet. Tube feet are there for the locomotion, and these generally protrude through the special radial canals. So there is a water vascular system in the body of these echinoderms for locomotion. The exoskeleton is present, which is spiny and is made of calcareous plates. You can see here the water vascular system. There is an opening called as the madreporia, madreporite, which opens into the water vascular system. So there is a circular tube, the canal is there, which will take the ring canal will take the water to the water radial canal, which are there on the five radiating canals, radiating arms. So each arm is having a radial canal, and the radial canal has got the tube feet arranged. So on the radial canal you will find the tube feet, which help in the locomotion. So the water canal system is actually part of the larval coelom, which is modified into the water filled umbilical or the water vascular system, umbilical system or the water vascular system, with the tube feet to help in the locomotion. There is an opening plate which is called as madreporite, which permits the entry of water into the water vascular system. Digestive tract is usually complete. Then respiration is by gills in echinoderm. Circulatory system is greatly reduced and is open type. There are no excretory organs in echinoderms, but their nitrogenous waste is diffusing out through the gills or whatever the respiratory organ is, and through the tube feet also. Sexes are separate in echinoderms. Male and females are alike externally, and fertilization is generally external. Then life history includes ciliated bilaterally symmetrical larval forms. The name of the larva is Bipinnaria ophiopluteus, Echinopluteus. Different names are there of the different larval forms. Now, what are the unique features of the phylum Echinodermata? So most important is the bilateral symmetry in the larval form and the radial symmetry in the adult form. Then there is the endoskeleton of calcareous plates, usually with spines, which are actually the external ones, calcareous plates. Then modification of a part of the coelom into the water vascular system, which helps in locomotion, and tube feet is there for the locomotion.